two, one, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. We're sure glad to see you today. We're going to do something a little different. We do a lot of wrenches, screwdrivers, mechanical tools, but today we've got a nice Stanley Bailey number 4 plane that we're going to restore. It's going to be a nice project, so let's get on down to the shop and get started.
Before I get to the restoration, got a nice little new shop tool I'd like to show you. Since I've got plenty of Ryobi batteries with having quite a few of their tools, they've got a new magnifying lamp that fits right onto their battery platform. And this thing is just wonderful. At my age, it can never have too much light or too much magnification. Basically, it's got two light settings, one bright and then a lower one and then off, you know, and different magnifications. The standard magnification is 2.5 times. And then there's a little bubble one in there that gives you 5 times magnification. Just to show you what it's about, here's an interesting little tool. This sits on my workbench. I use this tool more than just about any tool I've got. It's just a little know-nothing screwdriver. It's just the right size to open paint cans and waxes and different things and work on small screws. And it's just handy. And I don't know, I've just got to be one of my little shop tools I use a lot. But anyway, you can see the magnification, if I can get it pictured right here. Here's the standard. Then when you go into here, here's the 2.5 times, and then you go over here and it's the 5 times. So anyway, it's handy. You can move this around and position it where you want. You can get it right above the work surface. If you're working on something, you need to get in close and get a good look at it. Just a handy little addition to the shop. Just another little show and tell before we get to the main feature. I got this little multi-tool a few years ago. I just really like the wood on it. It's a beautiful wood. I don't know much about it. I'm going to have to learn more about wood. It's one thing I'm really weak on. I've got to learn more of the different types of wood because I don't seem to know what I'm talking about. But this was a nice little tool I've had for a couple of years and enjoyed. And recently I came across another one, but this one just really caught my eye because, again, the beautiful wood on here. This is black walnut and absolutely gorgeous wood. Same tool, I guess the same brand. There's no maker's mark anywhere on either one of these tools. But this one just way heavier. And first I was thinking it was the wood, but when I opened it up, here's what I discovered. I mean, a full set of accessories. Screwdrivers, gouges, a nice little pry bar, drill bits. I mean, just on and on and on. Just a little bit of everything. See, I have 10 different accessories to go with this that fit right in the handle. So that was it's a real handy multi-tool to have if you don't have a lot, you know, another tool to work with. You've got, again, screwdrivers and all different things. Unfortunately, these were all made before Phillips was a big thing, so there's no Phillips accessories with this. So it's great for slotted screws. But anyway, nice little item. It's got to be complete that nothing else can fit in here. But again, just that beautiful black walnut wood caught my eye, so a nice little addition to my tool collection. My most recent visit to the flea market, I only came home with one item, but it's a pretty nice item. I think I made a decent buy. This is a Stanley Bailey number 4, actually a 4C for a corrugated bottom. I went to the, there's a site on there you can identify all your planes. It's really great. They ask you questions, show you pictures, and it leads you through and it tells you what you have. This one has got a blue finishing here, which is unusual. And it's got the knob up on a raised platform and a flat lip, not a raised lip. All those little different identifying remarks identifies this as a one made in 1962 to 63. The corrugated bottom, I read about it. The reason they put corrugated bottoms on planes was to give it less friction against the surface you're working on. However, it really didn't work out very well. Didn't get a very high rating from what I read, mainly if you were on an edge or at an, working around an edge or doing a bevel. This would interfere with it, and chips would get in the slots here. And also, it just the smooth flat bottom actually works better. It was an experiment they tried. I guess they didn't do a lot of testing because the market just didn't like it and basically said that it didn't really do the job. This one's in fairly good condition. It's pitted and stained. Badly pitted on the bottom here. And but the overall condition's pretty good, considering some of them I've looked at. It's all, you know, rusted all over. But the knobs themselves, except for one cracked part here, small one, and the handle itself is in good condition. So the wood's in, I call, pretty good condition. The again, the metal seems to be smooth and flat, even though it's, well, not smooth because these are rough spots on it, but it's flat and straight, I should say. Same thing on the bottom of it, the corrugated bottom. So I haven't done one of these in quite a while. I've got a few of them. I've got a Sexton, a Sergeant, a Pexto, and this last one, of course, a Stanley, the first Stanley I've gotten. And I mainly got it so I would have a Stanley, which is the granddaddy, the standard that all planes seem to be made from this. I may be wrong about that. I really don't know the history, but when you think of hand planes, you think of Stanley, and they've made them for many, many, many years. So I'm going to take this one down, give it a good cleaning and restoration, and see what we got. And here's the complete tear down of the Stanley Bailey plane. You can see the condition we talked about, but it did come apart without too much problem. What I really want to do, and you can see the blue color and more of it on here on this bottom section here that wasn't so exposed. I want to try to maintain that because matching that color really is not something I want to do. I want to maintain the original, so I want to clean this as best as I can to maintain the blue color inside here if I can. Keep it looking original. And I'm going to restore the wood on the handles, and of course all the metal will have to be cleaned and polished because it's in pretty sad shape. A couple of little brass parts. Also got a brass knob in here. Adjustment knob. And so we'll get this one all cleaned up and see about having a really nice Stanley Bailey plane. Yeah, it was nice to be working on something different. And before I call it a day, I want to show you where we are. We've got all the frog in the blades, cleaned and polished. They were just solid rust. I don't even know what you call this piece. Maybe that's the frog or maybe that's the frog. I'm not much on woodworking tools. Anyway, we've got this. You can see what the blue color looks like when it's cleaned. And, of course, that's the bottom side here. All that's covered up anyway. But the blue here on the basic body of it, you can see where there's rust that's gone all over. You know, the paint's rusted away. But I've cleaned it and polished it and waxed it and cleaned the inside as best I can. And I think I'm going to leave it like it is. It's got some aging on it. But that's, you know, that's a lot of years, and it happens. And I'm not going to try to paint it a blue that would probably look different than the original blue. So I've got it pretty clean. The wood on it, the knob and the handle here, that's still got to be sanded and restained and finished. All the little hardware has been polished. Some brass, some steel parts. So we've got most of the metal work done. Still got to do the bottom here, and I'll have to get down in these grooves, get to work on those and the sides. So that'll all have to be finished up. And with that's done, the basic, all the metal's done, then it's a matter of getting the handles finished up. So that's where we are now. Gonna call it a day. It's been a long day, a lot of hours. We'll pick it up later. Well, the restoration on the Stanley Bailey plane is complete. Stanley Bailey number 4 corrugated base. You remember how it looked when we got it? It was really rusty and bad on the bottom and the sides, and inside, couldn't even hardly tell it had a blue paint in it. It looked black. It was dark. The wood was, you know, needed refinishing. And so here's what we did. I guess I'll turn it this way so it matches the photo there. You can really see the difference here. That's all clean. Look how that wood turned out. Beautiful grain in the wood. This was, it was darker on the handle. I don't know why. It's a nice grain, but it just came out darker. Used the same ingredients on it. Inside, you can see the blue color. I was able to maintain that even though there's some wear and chipping and so forth. But it's the natural look. The corrugated base on the bottom, all cleaned up. The nice brass control knob there, all the hardware done. The Stanley name in here, you can see it was a gold, a yellow color. It was the Stanley color. I kept thinking it should have been red, and there's a lot of red ones, but I looked back the original one, and they all seemed, was able to get that recovered and looking good. Just a beautiful plane. Here you go, here's the name, Stanley, made in USA, very clear. Just all over, you can see the Bailey name in here and the number 4. So, you know, without painting, just by cleaning and buffing and shining, we've got a nice look. The wood is in really good shape. The handle's in great shape. And by stripping it down and refinishing it completely, it looks great. And again, this knob up front, just got a gorgeous grain to it. So, very pleased with it. We'll spin it around here and get a look at it from different angles to see how it looks. I dare say I've got four of them. I've accumulated over the time I've been doing restorations, and Stanley is the nicest one. Very, very happy with it. It was nice to do something a little different. I don't want to miss an opportunity to show off a little bit. So I got out the four planes I restored, and we'll take a look at them. Each one a little different, but all of them very nice. There they all are, looking quite nice.